current regional conditions. Special regional information. Your local 36-hour forecast from the National Weather Service. Long-range outlook. The regional forecast. The extended forecast. Local radar showing any precipitation and its movement during the past 90 minutes. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen. You're watching the Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to for accurate, dependable weather forecasts 24 hours a day.
You are tuned to the Weather Channel. Thanks for tuning in. Mike Bono and Jill Brown with you today. Just take a look at these temperatures. The Arctic cold, well, the Arctic has come south of the Canadian border into the states. We've got it into the 30s below zero in North Dakota and Minnesota again. The lowest temperatures around 40 below, and it ain't done yet. Tonight will probably be colder in many of these areas. Look at Chicago, 21 below zero. Their all-time lowest high temperature for the day, being 11 below. They're flirting with that. So in terms of the warmest it gets during the day, this may be the coldest or close to the coldest it's ever been in Chicago. Dayton, South Bend, the list goes on. Lots and lots of cold. Pittsburgh, 6 below. And if that's not all, in fact, this is all related. A lot of what's causing that cold is the snow cover. There's lots of snow on the ground, over 20 inches in parts of Ohio and West Virginia. Even southern Indiana has up to 20 inches. And, of course, parts of Kentucky up to 20 on the ground, as just since Sunday morning you've gotten a foot, a solid foot from Maine all the way down to Kentucky, and even on into the Midwest. We had 7 inches at Minneapolis. Milwaukee had 6 just the other day. Take a look at some of these snow totals. 30 inches, 2.5 feet in Ohio. We believe that's a snow depth, but they didn't have a whole lot before that started. Enfield, New Hampshire, Presque Isle, Maine, Wilkes-Barre, Pennsylvania. They are really snowbound in a lot of Pennsylvania right now, and of course Kentucky. This is what happened to that low. It has tracked on into eastern Canada, New Brunswick to be sure, with some snow showers still over the mountains of New England. If you think it's cold today in the mountains of New England, wait till tonight and tomorrow. So get out there and do a little skiing while it's still above zero. It's going to get cold again. But the good news for ski country, east lakes, south, is it's going to warm up by this coming weekend. So make your plans. Onward off Lake Michigan, some snow in the snow belts, Ohio, Pennsylvania, and New York State. We have a little bit of that on radar. Some snow showers around Ogunquit, Maine, moving out over the bay, Casco Bay. Back toward Lake Ontario, though, there's a hard streamer of snow coming in around Watertown, New York. This is lake effect snow. Erie mostly frozen over, but still some elements of snow coming on shore around Erie, PA. And the lake effect snow over Lake Huron showing up nicely. Some snow showers, the mountains of Pennsylvania and West Virginia. As the snow gun is on, just south of Watertown on the snow belt, 1-2 inches an hour easily, if not more. Southern Tier, Poconos, getting a little bit more of an icing on the cake after yesterday's big dump. But take a look at these wind chill temperatures. Chicago, 56 below. Minneapolis, not as bad as yesterday. We're close to 60 below, but look at the 70s below around Duluth, and actually warming up a little bit. The wind has calmed down in North Dakota. They were more than 80 below in some places yesterday. New York feels like 9 below. Pittsburgh 42 below with the big snowpack. It's got to be an Arctic type of a day in the Northeast. And even Atlanta feeling like below zero right now, 19 below in Nashville. The actual temps are 20 in New York. That's cold enough. But Atlanta won't get much above that 25. Charleston's 50 is going to drop. Still 73 in Miami. Just savor the moment, because even there it's going to cool down, and even more so in Tampa by tomorrow morning. Probably close to freezing in middle Florida. 27 only in Dallas. Then you go below zero. 14 below in Chi-Town. 19 below the Twin Cities. But to a point, Denver has got the warm air again, relatively speaking, with 34. 60s and even up to 70 in the mid-morning around the greater LA area. That's good for the cleanup operations. They really need some good weather, and kind of chilly in the Pacific Northwest. Our current weather map showing the boundary between the Arctic and the much milder air, with some fog in the valleys, kind of messing up what could be a beautiful weather situation in a lot of the Great Basin, that fog, and some shallow cold air, very cold air, but not making it past the Rockies, rising a little bit. That's why I'm going like this, giving you that snow. Some more snow off the lakes in the east, and still rain and even some thunder in South Florida. Well, there's the white stuff, the high clouds from our weekend, or actually Martin Luther King Day storm of yesterday. Some low clouds over East Texas. Sun and very cold in the south, even colder to the north. This is 90% snow cover, very few clouds. They are snowbound east of the Mississippi and north of about the Tennessee River. To South Florida we go, and we notice some moving rain showers only over South Florida, mostly the Everglades back to Naples, Everglades City, Dade County, Broward County. They have a little bit of rain. But wall-to-wall sun in the southwest and some low clouds again, Willamette Valley, Puget Sound, and parts of the Treasure Valley in Idaho. As we go to the forecast, looking a lot like today, looking a lot like right now, with some snow coming over the lakes and the Appalachians. Then this low begins to peel off to the east tomorrow. Not exactly an Alberta clipper, but some overrunning of that mild air in the Great Basin and Rockies over the top. Iowa gets a little snow remaining in a good chunk of the northeast. This high, though, will bring some near all-time record lows in the morning, and recovering a little in the afternoon, only because there will be little wind. But some of that snow still shoots off across maybe Kansas City and St. Louis. As to the west, no weather problems, hardly any weather at all. Just bits and pieces in the favorite snow belt and mountain areas, and South Florida gets a little precipitation. But this won't even be a tenth of an inch melted. That's why we don't have it on the green map. Some light snows brushing the Midwest, some lake effect snows in a lot of the east. As the highs look a lot more, that would be bad for lows, but it's highs. Look at the 80s in Southern Cal. These are the lows tonight. Read them and weep. Could be 20 below near Louisville, Kentucky. Then as we go on during the week, the big lift comes. The cold air gets lifted into Canada, 60 in Denver. Still warm in Southern Cal, but you'll see why the temperatures will be not as warm as they could be. On and off snow showers as fronts go across. But look at this, the promise of some precipitation on the west coast. It moves inland, even the southwest, which has been very dry, gets some precipitation by the weekend.
Find out what skiers have known for 50 years. Aspen Snowmass is the place to ski. Four ski mountains, Aspen Highlands, Ty Hat, Snowmass, and the legendary Aspen Mountain. Three new high-speed quads, 300 inches of champagne powder, breathtaking scenery, and of course, America's favorite ski town. Isn't it time you skied Aspen Snowmass? For information and reservations, please call 1-800-26-ASPEN.
Hit the slopes this winter with the Weather Channel's Yellow Pages Tour to Ski at these resort locations. Or for more information, call 1-800-864-2-SKI. That's 1-800-864-2754.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Coming up, a look at your local radar. But first, the current local conditions. Regional conditions. Your local 36-hour forecast from the National Weather Service. The extended forecast. Local radar showing any precipitation and its movement during the past 90 minutes. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen.
The average person spends one-third of their life sleeping, and that's why you should consider buying a Wonder Bed. Wonder Beds electrically adjust to any position for reading or watching TV, and it's been proven to help people with medical problems such as bad backs, hiatal hernias, poor circulation, or irregular breathing. With Wonder Bed, there's no pressure or obligation. If you're sick of companies that won't give you the price until you've had a high-pressure demonstration in your home, call Wonder Bed at 1-800-676-6661 for your free video and brochure. You'll see that our quality and prices are unbeatable. Wonder Beds come in all sizes and are easily connected to your existing head or footboard. The motor and mattress have a 15-year, 100% non-prorated guarantee with nationwide service. Wonder Bed guarantees your satisfaction with a 30-day money-back guarantee if for whatever reason you're not satisfied. So call 1-800-676-6661 to receive the free video and color brochure through the mail at no cost or obligation.
Well, a cold day today, and it may be worse yet tomorrow, but there is an improvement in the weather coming, and we'll be telling you about it coming up in just about 5 minutes. Stick around. Right now, a forecast, though, for today.
Of all the important things you need for an exciting, successful trip to the slopes this winter, this may be the most important of all. Tune to the Weather Channel at 8 minutes past every hour for the skier's forecast. Get up-to-the-minute ski information from major resorts as well as conditions for slopes near you. Get late-breaking weather affecting ski areas with next-day regional and national outlooks. The skier's forecast, hourly, all season long, only on the Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to.
Stay tuned for an important offer exclusively for people between the ages of 45 and 75.
If you're between the ages of 45 and 75, the Mutual of Omaha companies have a guaranteed life insurance plan that fits you perfectly. It costs less than a dollar a day, and it's guaranteed in five ways. You can't be turned down. There are no health questions. You don't even have to take a physical. Your benefits will never decrease. Your payments will never increase. And it can't be canceled, ever. Call this toll-free number for free information. Review it in the privacy of your own home. There's no risk or obligation.
Call today for your free enrollment packet at 1-800-304-5511. It's filled with valuable information about guaranteed life insurance for less than a dollar a day. Direct from the Mutual of Omaha Companies. Call 1-800-304-5511 and look for the official blue seal in your mailbox. It absolutely guarantees your acceptance.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Coming up, a look at your local radar. But first, the 36-hour forecast from the National Weather Service. Extended forecast.
local radar showing any precipitation in your area. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen.
Gardeners, if you love beautiful gardens full of garden fresh vegetables, big beautiful flowers and elegant landscape plantings, but hate the time and back-breaking work it takes, here's great news. Introducing the affordable Troy-Build Pony, designed and built especially for home gardeners. The Troy-Build Pony is an amazing time and work saver, turning any soil into perfect planting beds quickly and easily, working rich organic matter into your soil, building exciting new flower gardens and border plantings. You can even reseed your lawn or dig a deep trench for planting shrubs. Plus, you'll love having your own garden fresh vegetables all season long. So if you want to learn more about getting results like this, the fast, easy Troy-Build way, call for your free catalog today. Call now and we'll also include complete details on our Troy-Build easy payment plan. For your free catalog featuring the pony and our whole line of Troy-Build tillers, including our no-money-down easy payment plan, call 1-800-441-3434. That's 1-800-441-3434. Call now.
Take a trip over to Europe now. We'll take a look at temperatures. First off, 19 in Moscow. Not unusually cold for this time of year. And they were reporting light snow today. Sounds about right. 32 in Frankfurt, 32 in Paris. We've now had a little drop in temperatures, although it may warm up just a tad tomorrow before the next front comes on through. Let's take a look at the satellite picture, and you can see an impressive-looking storm front heading towards the British Isles. They had rain today in Dublin and on over towards London. Looks like Paris may get it tomorrow. Kind of a slow-moving front should be pressing its way across the continent. It's been a stormy season, a lot of problems, and it looks like the same sort of pattern coming in, at least for the next couple of days. Here's the forecast then for midday on Wednesday. Snow to the north, but rain cutting down across Germany, France, and over towards Amsterdam, perhaps quieting down somewhat. A little breezy, though, across the British Isles. And the interior part of the continent looks fairly quiet. There you go, just ahead of the front, temperatures warming up into the 50s. And even some 40s where there were 30s today. In Athens, should be partly cloudy on Wednesday. Temperatures getting to the mid-60s, not bad. Showers for Brussels, cloudy and windy in London, mid-40s. Madrid will be sunny during the afternoon, only upper 40s though. In Paris, showers and mid-40s.
Planning a trip to the Orient? The latest Asian forecasts and travel information are just a phone call away. 1-900-WEATHER for 95 cents a minute. Weather information you need, whenever you need it. Direct to you by telephone. Call your source of weather information, the Weather Channel Connection.
Foster Brooks, the man who took Johnny Carson by surprise.
I said, what happened? He said, well, by the time we got a hole cut in the ice big enough for the motorboat, we were too tired to fish.
Appearing for 10 consecutive years in Las Vegas in the largest casinos. Jack Benny once said, no one wants to follow Foster on stage. Call the number on your screen now and order the funniest man alive. This veteran of The Tonight Show, The Dean Martin Roast, The Bill Cosby Show, The Smothers Brothers Show, and countless other TV shows.
I had one brother-in-law went ice fishing one day, brought him 200 pounds of ice. His wife fried it, and they both drowned. Held it up to his own head just like that, and she started laughing. He said, don't laugh, you're next.
The master of nightclub comedy would delight you with the funniest video ever. Now here's how to order. Call the number on your screen and ask for the Foster Brooks video for only $19.95, plus $4.95 shipping and handling per tape.
You're watching the Weather Channel for accurate forecasts at your convenience. Weather you can always turn to. Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Coming up, a look at your local radar. But first, the 36-hour forecast from the National Weather Service. Regional information. The regional forecast. The current local radar showing any precipitation in your area. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen.
it covers. How does PRISM's 24-hour roadside assistance work anyway? Can I get anti-lock brakes? Are the dual airbags really standard?
Before you buy a new car, you have a lot of questions. Call 1-800-GET-TO-KNOW and get to know all the answers about the Geo PRISM.
How about if I just take this one?
Look for private lesson ski tips every day on the Weather Channel, sponsored by Geo.
Hi, I'm Jim Palmer. There's still time to refinance your home at the money store, even if you have less than perfect credit. Over the last year, thousands of homeowners across America have refinanced their mortgages with the money store. You can apply by phone anytime at the money store, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and there's never an application fee. So to refinance your mortgage, even if your credit is less than perfect, call the money store at 1-800-LOAN-YES. The money store, where America goes for money.
Winter weather update. The storm is over. Now the snow is on the ground and the cold is coming on through. Thanks for tuning into the Weather Channel. Mike Bono and Jill Brown with the 1 foot mark of this storm alone. Ski country is reporting powder conditions anywhere from Maine to the lakes into the even southern Appalachians with new snow totals. This is really an Arctic blast. In fact, let's take a look at a satellite picture and see the snow on the ground. The Tennessee Valley has a snow cover. And of course, the mountains of North Carolina. A lot of the forests in the south will disguise some of that snow cover, but it's down there, even into the northeast corner of Georgia. Not a whole lot of clouds moving through the Ohio Valley. This is 90% snow cover on into New England and back on into the Midwest. Let's take a look at some of the snow depths and storm totals that we've had. Up to 30 inches in eastern, southeastern Ohio, New Hampshire, Maine, over 20. That's just new snow. We now have depths ranging up to 70 to 80 inches in northern Vermont at some of the observing sites, to 40 to 50 in the Adirondacks of New York. There's a lot of snow on the ground. A lot of Maine has over 2 feet. Ludlow, Vermont, 18 inches. Look at Louisville, Kentucky. I believe in that particular metro area, it was the biggest single storm on record. Wow. Look at these temperatures, 30s below zero, and wind chills even worse than that. Chicago, 21 below, is struggling to get up to 10 below today. I believe if they don't get up to 10 below, it'll equal their all-time lowest high temperature for any day. South Bend, 18 below. Pittsburgh, 6 below. It is bitterly cold. And the wind over the Great Lakes, parts of the lake still unfrozen, mostly. Erie is the one that freezes first. But nonetheless, we're still getting lake effect and some mountain snows, and also a stripe of snow in parts of the high plains. Look at these temperatures. Read them and weep. Still 14 below in Chicago, 4 below in Pittsburgh. That's headed eastward. Also southward, and the wind chills, 54 below in the Twin Cities, even colder in Chicago. As we see the forecast for tomorrow coming in, very cold, finally moving on east. You got to take those precautions, because when the wind chill gets below 25 below, you will certainly get frostbite if you're not protected. Now here's Jill.
Alrighty, thanks, Mike. We'll take a look at our forecast, and it looks like we have one more day of the icy chill, and then we should see some improvements as we head into the weekend. Actually, it's going to look a whole lot better by the weekend compared to what we have today. Here's the leading edge of our cold air cutting right down through the bottom peninsula of Florida by this afternoon. So a few more showers here and then you're done. We'll be a little cooler behind it. In the 50s, it's a shower in Tampa, which by local standards is chilly, but nothing compared to what they're dealing with. Even as you head up to Atlanta in the 20s, as you head farther to the north, windy and snowy. The lake effect snow is kicking in. We may see more than a foot in a few spots. Now here's the back edge of the cold air. And sure enough, the West is sticking with what they've had, and that is basically dry conditions, mild temperatures, even a couple of record highs on the West Coast yesterday. Some changes for you this coming weekend as well, as we may see some wet weather coming in, but we don't see that through Wednesday afternoon. So tomorrow looks cold, but still relatively quiet. A couple spots of precipitation here and there, mainly snow to the north. A little clipper cutting across, so maybe another 1 to 3 in the plains.
In my line of work, we go through a lot of sheet metal. So I know a little something about replacement parts. Did you know that some insurance companies specify cheap imitation hoods, doors, and fenders for GM cars and trucks? It's true. And a lot of that cut-rate stuff doesn't measure up to GM standards. Facts are all right here in this free brochure. So take some advice from a guy who's been through a fender or two. Ask to see your repair order before insurance work begins and insist on genuine GM parts.
Visit your nearest Mr. Goodwrench Quick Lube Plus dealers. She flies into icy winds 30 feet above the ground, but she won't take chances with her lips, so she takes ChapStick Medicated, triple medicated relief to soothe and prevent chapped lips. Take lip care seriously. Take ChapStick.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Current regional conditions. Special regional information. Your local 36-hour forecast from the National Weather Service. The regional forecast. The extended forecast. Showing any precipitation and its movement during the past 90 minutes. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen. Dressing your kids for school can be downright elementary when you watch the school day forecast weekday mornings 35 minutes after the hour on the Weather Channel, weather you can always turn to.
And now it's time for the Michelin Drivers Report, brought to you by Michelin and your participating Michelin dealers.
We still have some wintry travel on the map, and of course, even though the snow is over, there's a lot of wind and it's a very fine snow. The temperatures are falling well below freezing, so whenever you have that formula, throw in a little wind and it blows right across the interstates, and you have your open fields, for instance, as you're driving up and down I-91 through Vermont, New Hampshire, and Massachusetts, crosswind will bring those little patches of snowy travel. Even though you might be dry, all of a sudden you go around a bend and it's either icy or snowy. And not a whole lot of dry roads, not with a foot to two of snow that you've had since yesterday. So driving a problem, and even some snow falling through much of the Appalachians and lakes all the way back toward Indiana. Our wintry travel on the map, even into Montana and Wyoming, and some rain over South Florida. Let's take a peek at the national picture of satellites with a little bit of snow in Montana and Nebraska. And South Florida, that's rain, and some snow to the north. This is all very cold, snow-covered ground. Windy travel as well in the eastern part of the United States.
Rangers. Cherokees. Broncos. Explorers. Pathfinders. Blazers. Any pickup or 4x4. On road or off. Introducing the tough new LTX Light Truck Series from Michelin.
Find Michelin tires at this dealer near you, because so much is riding on your tires.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Coming up, a look at your local radar. But first, the current local conditions. Regional conditions. Your local 36-hour forecast from the National Weather Service. the extended forecast. Special regional information. The forecast for cities nationwide. Forecast. Your local radar showing any precipitation and its movement during the past 90 minutes. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen. You're watching the Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to for accurate, dependable weather forecasts 24 hours a day.
All right, let's take a look at this afternoon's weather. The big story is still the cold air mass covering the eastern third of the country, while in the west, the weather, thankfully, is quiet to give the folks in South California a chance to clean up after the earthquake. And actually, it looks like dry weather is in the forecast for at least several days. We are looking to the west because there is a forecast change in the upper-level winds or the jet stream, which may usher in a storm as we get towards the very end of the week and then on through the weekend. But that's a considerable number of days away at this point, so right now, we're just looking at this area of low pressure as it spins itself around here in the Pacific. But going back about 12 hours or so, it does appear that the system is moving very, very slowly towards the east. Dense, thick fog, the problem today across West Washington and Oregon. A lot of the moisture which has come in off the Pacific Ocean at low levels in the atmosphere. Now, there's an awful lot of warm air if you go up 5,000 or 6,000 feet above the ground. But that doesn't do anybody good down below because we have a layer of cool air which is trapped down near the ground, and that's why we're holding the clouds and the fog in. Over the east, the large pool of cold air sweeping down towards the south. Temperatures just barely getting up around 20 degrees around Birmingham, Alabama in the past hour. It's cold all the way down towards parts of North Georgia into the westernmost Carolinas, and the leading edge of the cold air has pushed on south into Florida. However, we do have some clouds as you head into central and south Florida, and there is a bit of light rain with that frontal system as it moves towards the Keys this afternoon. All right, let's go ahead and check the forecast. Now, we do have some lake effect snow today. The radars across New York having a little difficulty picking up some of the snow, especially off Lake Ontario. However, if you live or plan on traveling up I-81 there through Lewis County, Oswego County, we do have some heavier snow there, and the band hasn't been moving all that much during the course of this morning and now into this afternoon. So we suspect there's been some heavier snow in that squall, which has been very persistent off Ontario. And also, even though Lake Erie is practically all ice covered, we're getting some lake effect coming in south of Buffalo around Cattaraugus and Chautauqua counties, and then also just south of Buffalo in southern Erie County. We have some heavier snow coming in with the wind coming in at just the right angle off Lake Erie. As you come to the west, this front represents the Arctic air as it's slid back towards the mountains. However, the winds are picking up now in the high elevations, and as some of the air is forced down towards the plains in Colorado, it's helping to blow some of that Arctic air out farther east into the plains. So there may be a fairly large temperature difference today between the foothills west of Denver, and then as you come on out into the northeastern corner of the state because of the transition from the Arctic air
into some of the milder Pacific air. And eventually, we are going to help start pushing this front a little farther east during the day tomorrow. It may start out by morning, still stuck back in Colorado, but it'll be working its way on east during the morning hours. High pressure centered over Kentucky, and with that fresh snow cover now on the ground across all of the Ohio Valley and the light winds and generally clear skies tonight, this may be one of the coldest nights on record ever for some spots. That's how intensely cold this air mass is. And coming down towards the south, this will be probably the coldest night, at least this season, for many folks in North Mississippi, Tennessee, North Georgia, and Alabama. And look out, here come the east winds. In fact, we're going to have a couple of days probably where east winds will come in across the Atlantic, right on back into the Gulf of Mexico. And the reason for that will be the position of the high pressure. It's going to be sitting up along the mid-Atlantic coast for a good period of time. Over the west, things are quiet. There'll be some patchy light snow perhaps across Missouri and on back into southeastern Montana. But generally, we're not expecting much precipitation in the next few days. No major storms. Any precipitation in the form of snow, which rips across the country, will be fairly light, except in those localized lake effect snow squalls. A best chance of heavier precipitation in Florida will be in the southern tip of the state as the front continues to track south. And there is some moisture in from about 5 and 6,000 feet above the ground and higher that's coming in from the southwest. So that may keep the clouds in there for quite some time. The snowfall amounts, well, they'll vary a bit. If you're downwind of the lakes and the wind direction is just right, you could get some heavier snow. That may be the case as you go on up into the Cadillac Hills in northern lower Michigan this afternoon and tonight. I could see over 6 inches in some spots. Likewise in Lewis County in New York, and also as you go over to Oswego, some of those snow bands may start to shift a bit farther south later this afternoon, although so far they have been pretty persistent, staying focused over the same area. Highs this afternoon, if you want to call them highs, 20 below zero, or hoping in parts of west central Minnesota. Right now, the coldest air is located right here in a small area in west central Minnesota with readings of about 25 to 28 below zero. Warm in the southwest, some 80s expected in the interior of Southern California. And then the deep freeze tonight. This may be one of the coldest nights a lot of us have seen in quite some time, if not ever, as the fresh snowpack, the clear skies, and the light winds will really make those temperatures fall incredibly. As you go into the daytime hours tomorrow, not much recovery in some areas, single digits perhaps in the Ohio Valley, 20s across parts of the southern Appalachians, still very comfortable in the southwest through Thursday and Friday with highs in the 70s and 80s. And then finally, as we go from Friday into the weekend, the air starts to modify quite a bit with the help of some sunshine. And holy cow.